Hello friends, in this video I am going to solve a problem on compressible fluid. So here a problem I am writing: air is expanded reversibly and adiabatically in a nozzle from 13 bar and 150 degree Celsius to a pressure of 6 bar. The inlet velocity of the nozzle is very small and the process occurs under steady flow condition. So calculate the exit velocity of the nozzle. So in this problem we have to given here, I'm draw HS diagram, and here is a nozzle. At entry point its velocity is very small as compared to exit velocity, and nozzle is expand at inlet point, pressure is 13 bar, at outlet point is 6 bar, and temperature at inlet is 150 degree Celsius. So here first I am write P1 is 13 bar, temperature 423 Kelvin, and P2 pressure is 6 bar. So here I am apply steady flow energy equation. So you can write M into H1 plus C1 square by 2 G Z1 plus Q equal to M into H2 plus C2 square by 2 plus G into Z2 plus W. So here is M is a mass flow rate, H1 is your enthalpy at inlet, and C1 is the inlet velocity, and Z1 is your from here. I am consider from here to here. And datum line. So Z1 is equal to Z2 and consider here. So this one is cancel, and this one is from apply steady flow energy equation. So there is and every process is adiabatically. So that is, this one is zero neglect and is no work transfer, I can assume here. And Z1 is equal to Z2. So finally we write H1 plus C1 square by 2 equal to H2 plus C2 square by 2. So I can simplify. So you can write H1 minus H2 equal to C2 square minus C1 square by 2. So this one is very small, so that's why I'm here is negligible this one. So you can write C2 equal to 2H1 minus H2. Now I can also write this one is C2 is equal to 2 into Cp into T1 minus T2, because here is not enthalpy are given, but temperature T1 is, you know, T2 you can find with the help of process 1C2 is reversible adiabatic process. So you can, you know that T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 is gamma minus, power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So here is T1 is given, you know this, P2 given, P1 given. So you can find here T2 is 339.16 Kelvin. So substitute this value in this equation. So you can write 2 into Cp is also, you know, 1.005 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, and temperature T1 is 423. And temperature T2 is 339.169. So finally we got the answer 12.98 meter per second. Thank you friend for watching this video.